This is the NBC Television Network. Tonight on a special presentation of the magical world of Disney.
The grand opening of the Disney MGM Studios theme park.
Join James Stewart, Smokey Robinson, Jane Fonda, John Forsythe, Stephanie Powers, Buster Poindexter, Kate Jackson, Dick Van Dyke, Ann Miller, Ashburton Simpson, Suzanne Summers, Kathy Lee Crosby, Tony Randall, Rue McClanahan, Estelle Getty, and more superstars and more famous cars.
This is going to be great.
The Disney MGM Studios theme park grand opening, a world premiere exclusive next on the magical world of Disney.
Hello, I'm Michael Eisner. In the great tradition of Hollywood, I'd like to welcome you to a major studio sneak preview. Tonight, the Disney MGM Studios theme park will officially open to the public. But as the final touches are being put on this wonderful new theme park, we're going to give you a glimpse of what all the excitement is about. We're also going to try and give you a sense of what this thing called Hollywood is all about. When we think of movies, we think of entertainment. But the greatest films have done much more than simply entertain. They've enlightened us, inspired us, and helped shape the world in which we live. Each of us has a favorite movie, one that has stuck in our minds and influenced our lives. Mine was Pinocchio. I'll never forget the first time I saw it. It inspired in me a sense of awe and beauty and creative possibilities that have stayed with me all my life. Tonight, we're going to talk to some pretty remarkable people about the films that have affected them. I think you'll be fascinated with what they have to say. So sit back and enjoy this sneak preview of the Hollywood we've created in Florida. It's not so much a theme park as a state of mind. A Hollywood that never was and will always be.
Welcome to the grand opening of the newest, most fantastic attraction at Walt Disney World. The all-new Disney MGM Studios theme park. Starring, in alphabetical order, Harry Anderson. Ashford and Simpson. George Burns, Joy, Monica, and Leanna Creel, Walter Cronkite, Jane Fonda, John Forsythe, Estelle Getty, George S. Irving, Kate Jackson, Rue McClanahan, Ann Miller, Eve Montan, Willie Nelson, Buster Poindexter, the Pointer Sisters, Stephanie Powers, Tony Randall, John Ritter, Smokey Robinson, Mickey Rooney, Suzanne Summers, James Stewart, Dick Van Dyke, and special appearances by Ronald Reagan, Margaret Thatcher, and Lech Walesa.
We'll be right back.
tree. Plots to bring disaster. Jason couldn't be much faster. Pageant orchestrated masterfully. Illusions, fantasies to stud. Battles dangerous or bloody. So join us. Everybody can see. We got magic to do.
On just for you.
All our miracles on display.
On display.
We've got parts to perform.
Parts to warm.
All those scenes from silver screens. As we go along.
That is the magic of movies. Hi, I'm John Ritter, and I've been sent down here by the Disney people as sort of a special emissary to see that everything's perfect and ready to go before the grand opening of these incredible studios. Can you believe this? I just left Hollywood, California, and here I am in Hollywood, but in Florida. Now, would you look at that? The Chinese Theater. I just entered through the studio gates, and right over here is the old Hollywood Brown Derby restaurant. All these landmarks that mean Hollywood to much of the world, all recreated here at the Disney MGM Studios theme park in Florida. What they have done is built movie studios that combine business and pleasure. The business of making movies and the pleasure of the public who can watch the movies and television shows as they're being made. To give you an idea of the size, let me put it into perspective. The studio tour and theme park area is 135 acres, making it one of the largest movie lots in America. And that 135 acres fits into Walt Disney World, which is twice the size of Manhattan. We're not talking theme park, we're talking theme country. There's a lot to do before the gala opening, but I think we can get it done. After all, we've got 2 full days.
Excuse me, Mr. Ritter.
Yeah.
I'm on my way to my post, and I overheard you say something about the opening. It's not 2 days, it's less than 2 hours.
2 hours, 2 days, you see, that doesn't faze me, because as the great showman P.T. Barnum once said, less than 2 hours before the grand opening?
I don't remember P.T. Barnum saying that.
Less than two, it's less than, all right, everybody, we've got to move, it's less than 2 hours. We have to move, we're on TV, come on, move it.
Harry Anderson's World of Special Effects, Kate Jackson, and a movie memory from Ronald Reagan when he returns.
I like the way you make me laugh. I like the funny things you do. You got a style that's all your own. I like the sprite in you. You make me wanna smile. You know you make me sparkle too. You're such a kick to have around.
Sprite, the only one with Lyman, the unexpected twist that makes us different.
I like the sprite in you.
For McDonald's salads, Kathy.
Itchy girl.
And Iron Mike Ditka.
Big ox.
They come from separate worlds.
It's a man's world.
It's a human's world.
They want different things.
A good quarterback.
Okay.
But there's one thing they both love.
Golf.
No, McDonald's salads. Loaded with fresh vegetables for loads of taste. With 3 new McDonald's own dressings, like tangy Caesar, creamy peppercorn, and reduced calorie red French.
After you, Mike.
Thanks. Nice girl.
Big ox.
What's the big idea behind Lifesavers Fruit Juicers candy? The great taste of fruit juice in a spill-proof container. Fruit Juicers, the first hard roll candy made with real fruit juice.
Gary, it's time I taught you something every man should know. How to eat an Oreo cookie.
Twist it off. Just give it a lick.
It's hard to hide the kid inside.
Now you just learn to tie your shoelaces and you'll be all set.
I see your true colors shining through. True colors shining through. Don't be afraid to let them show.
The best moments of your life deserve the most true-to-life colors. Kodak Color Gold 100 Film.
Your true colors.
We now return to the grand opening celebration.
Now, you see, I have to make sure that everything's working, so don't panic. We're going to meet the deadline, and everything will be fantastic. Let's see, we've got the stuntmen, showgirls, 7 piano-playing monkeys on risers. Are they here? We're not sure about that, but I'm sure they'll be here. 100 redheads, I personally supervise that. 600 dancers, 1 Willie Nelson in performance, good. Thousands of fireworks, check. At least 3 singing and dancing Pointer Sisters. All right, a host of marching bands, 1 inimitable George Burns and streamers. Do we have this? We have the streamers. Tap dancers and trained flying birds, good, and much, much more. But before all that happens, I've got to make sure that everything's ready. So why don't you come along with me and check it out for yourself, okay? But first, just meet me back here in about a minute, all right? Don't go away.
That's it, Miss Jackson.
Thank you, Linda.
You look lovely.
Oh, thank you. Hello. I'm originally from Birmingham, Alabama, and I saw a lot of movies when I was growing up, but it wasn't until I was about 20 that I first saw Casablanca, and it really made an impression. It was a romance, of course, and, you know, being 20, I went right along with that, but there was more. See, I can still remember the first time I saw the scene at the airport at the end. You know, I had my handkerchief out just like everybody else. But when I left the theater, I took something else with me. It was the first time that I'd really thought about honor as a living experience.
No, no.
always looking at you, kid.
Hi. What you looking for?
Oh, excuse me. I think I left my Mickey Mouse Club jacket in here. Have you seen it?
No, maybe somebody took it back to the dressing room for you.
Maybe it's over here.
Oh, great, you found it.
Great.
So tell me, are you a member of the all-new Mickey Mouse Club?
I sure am. Our studio's right down the hall.
Uh-huh. The Mickey Mouse Club is a Disney tradition that started many years ago.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me?
M-I-C-K-E-Y-M-O-U-S-E.
Over 25 million kids signed up for a half hour each afternoon after school, and now their kids are the charter members of.
We've got a deadline, and nobody's working. Where is everybody? Come on, people. This is supposed to be called Catastrophe Canyon. I want to see some action. I want to hear some action. I want to feel some action. And now it's raining. This is not good. We're going to be rained out tonight. What is this? Look out below!
Is there a horn on this bee? Hey, follow that B-52. But be careful or you'll be sorry.
What's this?
20,000 leagues under the bee? Hi, I'm Harry Anderson, and this is my friend, the bee. He insisted on being here for the grand opening. I call him Bear. See, they have this other bee that they call Square. I wasn't sure whether I should ride Be There or Be Square. This is a good demonstration of a beautiful special effect called chroma key. Wherever the camera sees blue, a whole new background can be substituted.
And when it's all put together, the final result is movie magic.
Thank you.
we're here in the special effects warehouse where they make and store all the special effects props. The mad scientists who work in this place must be out for a late lunch. Wonder what this thing does. Just kidding. What do we have here? Well, well, this must be what they call the Ronald Ray gun. And over here, look at this beauty. A perfect little model of the Dipmobile from the film Who Framed Roger Rabbit. You know, this room is filled to the rafters with creatures and critters and creepy crawlers.
Some made you laugh, some scared you to death.
Wow! Place is going nuts! You know, all of these props were made for specific motion pictures. And if you weren't afraid to peek, you might have seen some of them.
It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Because I was afraid to speak when I was just a lad. My father gave me nails a tweak and told me I was bad. But then one day I learned a word to say we ain't can knows.
He traveled all around the world and everywhere he went, he'd use his word and all would say, there goes a clever gent.
When Dukes and Martha Rogers pass a time of day with me, I say me special word and then they ask me after tea.
Ooh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
That last film certainly had a handsome leading man. Well, that's one kind of special effect. Here's another. Looks authentic, don't it? This is where those exciting naval battles, like the ones you saw in War and Remembrance, were actually fought. The South Pacific and the ships of the line, right here, in the studio back lot, in the big tank of water. That back there is a naval fireboat. You know, they've got this great gag with this tugboat and that wheelhouse. But it's never been tried before, and I don't know where we would find a sucker stupid enough to get in there the first time.
Harry! Harry, there's less than an hour to the grand opening party. Is everything here set?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Well, there is one thing that hasn't been checked out yet.
What's that?
The wheelhouse.
The wheelhouse isn't ready? Somebody should check it out.
Well,
come
yeah,
on.
You know, John, you're right, but I don't know where we would find somebody at this hour.
Okay, fine, I'll do it.
Great. Here, put this on.
Put this on?
Yeah.
Why do you want me to put this on?
Because then you look like the little guy in the boat.
Why would I want to look like the little guy in the boat?
Because he's cute.
He's cute?
Yeah, and so are you. This looks very good on you.
Oh, good.
It does. I mean, it's kind of a bold fashion statement, but it works.
Well, I like to look like a little guy in the boat, but listen, I got to be finished in less than an hour because the party... Where's my watch?
I'll hold on to this till we're done, okay? Come on, this is going to be fun.
Is this going to be fun?
Yeah, and I know fun, John, and this is going to be fun. You go on in there.
I should go in here?
Let's get in there and hold on to the wheel,
Harry,
and then we'll have fun.
It's very moist in here.
Huh?
It's very moist.
Are you having fun yet?
Well, Harry?
Yeah?
This is not too steady in here.
No, it's fine, John, really, it's fine.
Well, I don't feel so fine. I feel a lot of queasosity starting to come up.
All right, now... By intercutting the model in the tank with a close-up of John in the wheelhouse, we give the special effect of John in a storm at sea, including a giant wave.
A giant what?
Wave! What a sap.
Harry. I got a little moist in there. I think it needs some adjustment.
No, that's the way it's supposed to work. It was swell.
But I'm soaked.
Yeah, ain't you?
Yeah.
Well, wardrobe could dry you off.
Right. Wardrobe!
No, John, you need this, don't you?
Oh, yeah, thanks, pal. It's still ticking. Wardrobe! Makeup! Nurse!
1939 is generally thought of as a milestone year for films. That was the year that we saw Gone with the Wind, Stagecoach, Wuthering Heights, The Wizard of Oz, Goodbye, Mr. Chips, Of Mice and Men, and Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. An unforgettable year for motion pictures. I saw all of those films and appreciated all of them, but one of them had a great impact on my life. Mr. Smith Goes to Washington. When Jimmy Stewart walked the halls of the Capitol building, I walked with him. When he stood in awe of that great man at the Lincoln Memorial, I bowed my head too.
All you people don't know about lost causes. Mr. Payne does. He said once they were the only causes worth fighting for. And he fought for them once. For the only reason any man ever fights for them. Because of just one plain, simple rule. Love thy neighbor. And in this world today full of hatred, a man who knows that one rule has a great trust.
I began to realize, through the power of that motion picture, that one man can make a difference.
John Forsythe, Dick Van Dyke, and the Indiana Jones Epic Stunt Spectacular when we return.
Heinz Cat Food asks, what would happen if cats ran the world? People would average 67 naps a day. Chasing balls of yarn would replace baseball as the great American pastime. And people would have to buy their cats Iams cat food, sold only by pet specialists. Because the nutrition in Iams makes a healthy difference you can see and your cat can feel. Iams, special pet foods found only at special places.
I know, off the couch.
Introducing the official car of the new Disney MGM Studios theme park in Florida.
Hi, everybody!
Meet the 1990 Lumina from today's Chevrolet.
See you real soon!
The new Chevy Lumina's four wide swing outdoors and the most passenger room in its class make it easy to get into. Very easy. Introducing the 1990 Family Lumina from today's Chevrolet.
Fabric softener.
Fresh as the morning breeze, fresh as the morning dew. Now everything you wash smells fresh and new.
It's true. With new Morning Fresh Snuggle Fabric Softener,
everything you wash smells fresh and new.
Let's work fast before our faces know we're gone. Buy more Tang for your kids.
Only Tang is vitamin C and four of the vitamins.
Buy more Tang.
I just bought some.
That's funny. We just drank some.
Tang drink with vitamins. The taste your mouth can't wait for.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Give me a break. Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar.
The Disney MGM Studios theme park grand opening will return after these messages.
Monday beat Earthquake Al. Whoa. When it hits, he's all shook up.
Earth is hazardous to your health.
We have a 2-week supply of food.
I ate it in 37 minutes.
On Nearly Departed, your favorite ghost may be invisible, but he keeps in shape.
That paper boy must be taking steroids.
I have the body of a dead man half my age.
After Al, Monday.
Every morning, Deborah Martinez goes to work. Every morning, she stops at 7-Eleven. Where before she catches the bus, she catches one of the best cups of hot coffee in modern times. Selected beans, ground fresh for each pot, on the spot, day in and day out. Fresh ground coffee on the fly at 7-Eleven, the sign of the times.
Steve Overton live from the MGM Disney Studios this week.
The one that I recall the strongest is Teutonic Knights, the movie that told about the struggle of the Polish nation in those times. It reassured me that sometimes you won't succeed without a fight. One must fight. Let the present time change the form of the fight. In today's world, you can fight peacefully, and that's the sort of fight I'm in. I do not imagine myself or other people without film. The film explains history or how it presents the struggle. We take it all for granted.
Most of you saw Raiders of the Lost Ark. You know that that was Harrison Ford battling that truck, not me. You don't know? Well, let's put it this way. You're right, it wasn't me, but you're wrong. It wasn't Harrison Ford either. It was his double, a stuntman.
You know, there's something so familiar about your voice.
Come on, Angel. Although Harrison Ford does a lot of his own stunts in his pictures, usually when an actor has to do something really hazardous in the course of making a movie, these folks, the stuntmen, take over. You learn how to fall and not hurt yourself. You learn how to stop on a dime and not move. You learn how to wield a mean sword like those folks at Durst. They've been rehearsing for some time for their part in this wonderful presentation of Daring Do. And boy, is the training tough. I tell you, ultimately, it's a breathtaking combination of athletic prowess, split-second timing, and rigorous rehearsal.
John, Kate!
Yeah.
You gotta get a move on. This park is opening in less than 2 hours, so please, anything you can do, help me. Please, people, we've all gotta work together.
My fault, sorry, that was... Oh, gosh.
Yeah!
We're fine. Just a...
I've heard of working in the sticks. This is ridiculous.
Hi, I'm Dick Van Dyke. You know, one of the perks you get after being in this business for a little while is when the script calls for an attractive young star, I am given not one, not two, but three lovely ladies. They're the stars of Parent Trap 3. These are the Creole triplets. And I'm going to show the girls some of my favorite places around the park. But first, let's find out which is which here.
My name is Joy. Mine's Leanna. My name's Monica.
Hi. I'm Dick Van Dyke. You can call me Mr. Van Dyke.
This place looks exactly like the Chinese theater in Hollywood. Even down to the footprints in the cement. I'd love to put my footprints in cement.
You know, there's two ways to accomplish that. You can become a famous film star, or you can rat on Big Rui.
Let's see if her feet fit. Pee Wee Herman and I have the same size shoe.
You're lucky. Mine match King Kong's.
Does anyone ever get stuck in this stuff?
Just him. Okay, girls, let's go. I want to show you around the park. This place is called the Looney Bin.
This place is so cool. Look, Joy, this is the Toon Patrol wagon from Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Hey, you guys, come listen to this. Hey, wait, look, here's another one.
Girls, come here. This is my favorite box. You gotta hear this. Okay, now listen. You know, I tried a spot remover once. Didn't take the stain out, but my dog disappeared. You know, once there were two farmers. Now there's more. Now there's more. That does it. I'm through telling jokes. Everybody's got to be a critic.
Hey, look over here.
Our next stop, the Monster Sound Show. Here's Liana dubbing her own voice for the Cheshire Cat from Alice in Wonderland.
Oh, but you must. She'll be mad about you. Simply mad.
But what I like best is horsing around, supplying all the hoofbeats for the legend of Sleepy Hollow. Joy and her sisters enjoy sharing the fun with some of sound effect wizard Jimmy McDonald's very bizarre contraptions. The Great Movie Ride is one of the highlights of the Disney MGM Studios theme park. Visitors find themselves right in the middle of the action in such great films as Raiders of the Lost Ark, Alien, and The Wizard of Oz.
I'll get you, my pretty.
And your little dog, too.
You know, that movie ride was really great. I'm ready to go again.
You know, that's the special thing about the movies. You can always go back again and relive all those wonderful memories.
When you think about it, movies have a lot to do with the way we live. And what about the way we talk? And the way we dress?
The way we walk.
Wait, the way we walk? Don't you think that's getting just a little carried away?
I guess maybe you're right. Hey, why don't I treat you all to a soda at the Brown Derby?
Okay.
Shall we?
Good evening. I'm Mickey Rooney. Every once in a while, someone will ask me, what movie made the biggest impression on me? Without thinking twice about the question, I always say, Love Finds Andy Hardy. Yes, I was lucky enough to make 17 of those Andy Hardy series, but it was in 1938 that I made that special one with a certain young 16-year-old girl named Judy Garland.
Betsy, you've grown up.
Am I sensational?
I'll say.
Well, Andy, even though I'm only a little girl, even little girls can see ahead. I was afraid there might be trouble, so I wrote Mother. She always understands. She's the one that sent me this sensational dress. She said that just once before I left Carville, I could be grown up. See, she even sent me a wrap. That's for the long drive home in the dark. Even though I'm not Cynthia.
Hey, this is going to be a world's record. I'm going to go put on my tuxedo with my opera hat. Maybe I'll shave.
Judy had such a magnificent talent. There was a certain vulnerability about this wonderful girl that made you want to take care of her. Audiences fell in love with her, and so did I. That's why my memories are so fond of Love Finds Andy Hardy. Thank you.
Tony Randall, Suzanne Summers, and a movie memory from Margaret Thatcher when we return.
It goes with the boys that play in the dirt. It goes with the joy. It goes with the hurt. It goes with the men you can't fix in. It's there when you lose.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Hi, two hot dogs, popcorn, and two Sprite.
Okay. Hey, he's pretty cute. You're looking for us, right?
Sprite, the only one with Lyman. The unexpected twist that makes us different.
Be right back. I like Sprite.
Why are we so hard on ourselves? When we created our original macaroni and cheese recipe, we insisted on aged New York cheddar, milk delivered fresh each day, and our own homemade noodles curved just so to hold the rich cheddary goodness inside. 35 years later, we still insist on all these things. Why? Because we're Stouffer's, and people expect us to be better than the rest.
You can find out what it would be like to be someone else.
Oh, boy.
Hi, Sam.
Ow. I'm a dork.
No, you're not.
Now I'm black?
Play it again, Sam.
He's looking at you, kid.
Now I think I'm starting to enjoy this.
Expose yourself to Quantum Leap.
Oh, my.
Quantum Leap moves to Wednesdays.
What are you doing for dinner?
This week.
We now return to the grand opening celebration.
I think the first film that really had a strong impact on me was Grapes of Wrath. I saw it when I was quite young. And before then, I think the only films that I'd ever seen were great big glamorous Hollywood adventures and romances. And suddenly here was this film that was so simple, so very real, and it was about poor people, the kind of people that if you were privileged and upper class like I was, you didn't normally think about or pay any attention to. And on top of it, one of them was my father, and they were getting into such trouble and being beaten and killed just for asking to be treated fairly. And then at the end of the movie, in the famous speech to his mother, my father said to her, maybe a man ain't got a soul of his own. Maybe he's just got a piece of a big one.
Fella ain't got a soul of his own, just a little piece of a big soul. The one big soul that belongs to everybody. Then...
Then what, Doc?
Then it don't matter. I'll be all around in the dark. I'll be everywhere. Wherever you can look. Wherever there's a fight so hungry people can eat, I'll be there. Wherever there's a cop beating up a guy, I'll be there. I'll be in the way guys yell when they're mad. I'll be in the way kids laugh when they're hungry and they know supper's ready. And when the people are eating the stuff they raise and living in the houses they build, I'll be there, too.
And it seemed to be saying that life should be about more than just me, and that you can commit your life to larger things, to larger values, and if people work together, they can attain those goals. That's, to me, what the movie represented, and certainly what my father represented.
Welcome to Superstar Television.
Superstar Television is a unique and oft-times hilarious attraction at the studio. Not only does it offer a delightful capsule history of TV, but in this theater, many of your favorite shows, from Gilligan's Island to Cheers, feature a very special guest star, you. Here's how it works. First, members of the audience are chosen to perform in the show.
Yes, you. Come on up here. Let's give her a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Right up through those steps.
Our fledgling actors are then hurried backstage for costumes and makeup.
New York. Do you have any experience in television?
I watch it.
Great, then you're in the show. Come with me. Right this way.
Today, on General Hospital.
The engineering geniuses placed the newly chosen, now costumed theme park guest into the existing footage of famous TV shows.
Hello?
This is Lucy Cope Jones.
I told you before, Donald isn't here.
Where is he? I have been trying to get him.
I'll bet you have. Look, Lucy, you stay away from my husband. Goodbye.
Bobby's television debut proved to be a dream come true. He got to work with Howard Cosell.
Well, tell me, what would you prefer? An appearance on The Tonight Show
or a guest spot with Howard Cosell.
I'm a jock. I'll take Cosell.
Great.
And now, Howard Cosell Sports Break.
The place, the big Shea Stadium. The championship resting on the bat of this player. The pitch, the swing, and it's out of here. A grand slam home run. The Mets win. Baseball fans will remember this one for a long, long time. And we have the individual voted most valuable player of this game. Now, how were you able to read that curve so accurately?
Gee, Howard, I really don't know. I just close my eyes and swing.
Modesty, honesty, too, and the science of hitting. Thank you, my friend, for being with us.
Thanks, Howard. My pleasure.
And that's this edition of Sports Break. I hope you can join us next time. Until then, Howard Cosell saying so long for now.
Have you ever wanted to make Johnny Carson laugh?
What was your least favorite picture that you did? And then maybe after you did it, said maybe I shouldn't have done it. Was there one?
The worst movie I ever made was a musical. I was supposed to play an accordion. And as you know, Johnny, I'm no magician. They won't even let me sing in the shower. But they made me do it anyway, and it sounded so bad, people just got up and walked out on me. And these people were on an airplane.
You can tell your grandchildren you once worked with Lucille Ball. And a happy surprise bunch of tour guest stars wave goodbye after their television debut.
It was in the early days of the war. I was young. I went rarely to the cinema, but we all went to see Mrs. Miniver. It was the story of an English family in an English village at the beginning of the war, amid the bombs, amid the raids on the village. Greer Garson played the title role. I remember so very vividly the scene when aircraft came and machine gunned the village. And it was the daughter who lost her life.
Oh, Carol. The village. Oh. Oh, we must get back there. They need help. Carol, what is it?
America hadn't then come into the war. It was something that America at that time did for us. It lifted our morale. And it had a tremendous effect in America. And I shall never forget it.
Wardrobe. In real life, you go to the mall. When you're making a movie, the mall comes to you. This is just another part of the magic. Oh, when I was a kid, I thought the movie musical numbers were the most exciting things I had ever seen. I wanted singing lessons. I wanted dancing lessons. And when I grew up, I knew that that was exactly what I wanted to do. I also learned why only big studios made big musicals. Because they had everything under one roof. The talent, the sets, the props, the costumes, the lights, and most importantly, a big empty stage. Somebody to think it up, somebody to say, okay, let's do it, and a team to make it all work. If it's going to wind up on Broadway, the artist is called the set designer. If it's for a film, he's the art director. But since this is television, this is the hand of the production designer. And then the craftsmen take over. The wood is pulled and cut and assembled and nailed and painted and lit and decorated. And it's the same thing in the wardrobe department. A little quieter, perhaps, but just as full of craft and technical artistry. And the interpretation of the music. Getting the sounds out of the musical director's head and distributed among the artists who will reproduce them. And then the exhilarating,
tiring work of rehearsal, the repetition of the steps and moves that flow from the choreographer's mind and feet into the rehearsed second nature of the performers. And finally, a legion of behind-the-camera professionals join the team. Director, cameramen, sound men, and grips, makeup artists, hairdressers, and many, many more all must unite in one final ultimate team effort, and suddenly it all comes together.
Everybody walk in place, please. Both positions. Stand by your track. Opening light cue, please. And here comes the track in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Return with Ann Miller, Buster Poindexter, and Ashford and Simpson after this.
Is that my little baby holding one of her own? Look at her loving touch. I see myself in her so much. Oh, I remember you, my baby, my own. How I would hold.
And Johnson & Johnson, the language of love.
It's gonna hurt.
Big hurts need the best care and lots of trust. The quality you trust is Johnson & Johnson. Our cloth tapes are made not to hurt coming off. Our nonstick pads won't stick to the wound. Johnson & Johnson, quality you trust.
Let me tell you about Welch's grape juice. Some juices you almost have to search for the taste. But Welch's grape juice, wow. You get this burst of conquered grapes. It's a taste you can feel from ear to ear. And it's so naturally sweet, they never add artificial flavors. You know, Welch's has been making it this way for more than 100 years. And as they say, practice makes perfect.
Did you know that certain kinds of diet frozen foods get 40, even 50% of their calories from fat? Fat. Eat smarter. The one you can trust is Le Menu Lifestyle. Every serving is under 300 calories, helps you limit sodium, cholesterol, and is low fat. The only thing we didn't touch is the taste. Le Menu Lifestyle. Eat smarter.
The Disney MGM Studios theme park grand opening will continue.
Friday, it's Muppets like you've never seen them before, with violence, suspense, and biting satire.
Quick, where's the nearest hydrant?
No time for that now. Can't you see we've got a fire to fight?
It's the all-dog spectacular Dog City, the world's first scratch-and-sniff gangster movie.
Make sure your dog is washing.
The Jim Henson Hour, Friday.
My first dance. And who danced with me except Jeffrey Kaiser, the biggest nerd? Cheer up, you're drinking milk, and this is you in a few years. Not with this brace face and gross hair. Well, you're growing fast, and milk can help you get a great smile and gorgeous hair. But my body, the only difference between me and the guys is this dress.
Hey, you can see we turned out just fine.
Who is that? That's Jeffrey Kaiser.
Milk, it does the body good.
Television. Get the picture? Use the power.
A brawl in the big leagues. Highlights at 11.
I got my first job as an actor back in 1932 on Broadway. And although it was right at the rock bottom of the Depression, the show business there was very, very good. And then I got a contract with MGM and came out to Hollywood. And I was loaned out for a couple of pictures, Frank Capra pictures. Frank said, I have an idea for a picture. It's called It's a Wonderful Life. It's about this fellow that was going to commit suicide and an angel named Clarence. Who hadn't won his wings yet, he came down and he saved him.
I knew if I were drowning, you'd try to save me. You see, you did. And that's how I saved you.
Very funny. Well, who are you then?
Clarence Oddbody, AS2.
Oddbody? AS2, what's that, AS2?
Angel, second class.
It's just been almost a part of my life. For all these years, and for this reason, this is my favorite film. It's a Wonderful Life.
Thanks, John, for pulling me out of the cement back there at the Chinese Theater.
Well, I wish I hadn't pulled so hard. Where did you finally land, anyway?
It was the street. I think it was called Dopey Drive, but I'll be fine. Listen, it's only a short while before the official grand opening, so I gotta go do a final check.
All right, see you later.
Just a little lower back pain. I'm okay.
All of the magic of storytelling lives here in this building, the Disney Animation Department. It's been designed to showcase the fascinating process of creating the animated films for which Disney is famous. More than 60 years ago, Mickey Mouse came to life on Walt Disney's drawing board, and since then, Disney and his animators have been the great innovators in the art and science of animation. But it still begins with a story, a soundtrack, and tens of thousands, sometimes hundreds of thousands, of individually hand-drawn pictures. Here in this area, visitors to the park can watch the animation artists at work. And they're a dedicated lot.
What gets me excited about animation really is the fact that you can, sit down at a table and with just a pencil and a piece of paper make something come to life.
Oh, hi, baby.
beg your pardon.
The more and more that you can become that character, the more you feel like that character, the better your animation will be.
An animator is an actor. He gets a scene, he has to act it out on paper.
The animator's rough drawings are then tested on videotape, cleaned up, and passed along to be photocopied on clear plastic sheets called cells. Meanwhile, the layout artists are creating the sets and the background artists are painting them. Walt Disney used 410 colors to do Sleeping Beauty. In choosing his colors, the background artist establishes the mood of the scene. In the ink and paint area, the individual cells are obviously inked and painted. Everything here has to be perfect because the next step is the camera department, where the finished cells are laid over the background and then photographed frame by frame. Now, when the film is run at normal speed, the characters move and seem to come alive. The special magic of Disney's animation, however, comes not from the process, but from the Disney artists who use it. It's they who chart the range of human emotions and infuse personality into cartoon animals and even inanimate objects.
You have to breathe the life into it. I think it's got to come out of the heart more than anything else. It's got to come from the heart through your arm, into your hand, and onto the paper.
Oh, that's really, really cool.
It's really creating characters that you can believe in and you can, you know, laugh with and cry for and love.
Oh, I just love happy endings.
And so, my friends, now you know some of the secrets behind the magic of Disney animation, technical, artistic, and emotional. Like all great art, it has and will endure because of its unique power to reflect and illuminate the human spirit.
Hello, my name is Stephanie Powers. It's a very interesting question. What was the film in your entire life that left the greatest impression? And for me, I have to go back to my childhood, and I must say that it was Bambi. Walt Disney never seemed to disappoint me in my childhood, but Bambi, that was extra special. But through that film, I learned a great deal about the dignity of animals and a bit about man's inhumanity to those lovely creatures with whom we share this extremely fragile planet. Shame that we haven't made a better life for Bambi and his mother. But perhaps we might. If we keep trying, we might get it right one day. If not in this generation, perhaps in the next. Thank you, Bambi. You certainly made me a better person.
It's just a little while until we swing open the gates on this, the newest attraction at Walt Disney World. And I thought I'd check out my favorite place to be at a movie studio. It's a fascinating area that we call the back lot. This is where there's even more movie magic. For example, this. Now, this could be an ordinary house on an ordinary street anywhere in the USA. But it turns into something special when the stars come out. Stars like Estelle Getty and Rue McClanahan from the Golden Girls.
Hi there, John.
Hello.
How about a bath, Herbie? Sit still, Herbie.
How come I can't get my car to do that? And why shouldn't Mickey and Goofy live here? The rent is reasonable, and they're very close to work. These are houses for all seasons. Summer turns to winter just by removing the flowers on the front lawn and adding a heavy snowfall. Well, adding snow flurries, anyway. But the most interesting thing about all these houses is that they're just shells. You see, you walk through the front door and there's nothing... Excuse me. I'm very sorry. Up here is more of the back lot. All those great gangster movies of the 30s left us the pawn shops and the diners of New York's Lower East Side. And the brownstone stoops of Manhattan's West Side, right over there. King Kong has left us the Empire State Building. And 42nd Street left us the Chrysler Building, right next door. Crocodile Dundee gifted us with the front entrance of that splendid hotel. You never know what you're gonna see around the next corner.
All right, I'll get him. Talk to him, right? Yeah, the dancers are on their opening marks. Hey, Buster, we're ready for you on the set now.
Oh, good.
Good.
This is gonna
be great.
Your
hair looks great, man.
Hey, watch it, kid. Okay, where do I go?
Right at the top of the stairs.
All right.
Right here, opening position, please. All right, stand by, everybody. Opening positions. This is all right here. Okay, New York Street production number with Buster Poindexter and George Irving. Scene one, take one.
New York, New York, a heck of a town. The Bronx is up, but the Battery's down. The people ride in a hole in the ground. New York, New York, it's a heck of a town.
Stop!
tell her, baby, won't you swing it with me? Oh, she gives me name, I wanna wing it a bit. So I say, politely, darling, me, I ain't sure. She said, don't you keep me waiting when I'm in my mood. No hesitating when I'm in my mood. The first of these are meeting when they're in my mood. The power of freedom, baby, I'm in the mood.
All right, hold. All right, that's great, kids. That's a wrap. That's a wrap.
Thank you.
Move on to the next set. Here we go.
Okay, here's your opening positions there. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's give it a shot. Okay, New York Street production number, 8th Avenue, Ashford and Simpson, scene 2, take 1. New York production number, and Miller, 42nd Street, scene 3, take 1. Thank you.
Miss Miller. Dancers, that was fantastic. All right, that's a wrap. Good night, everybody.
Willie Nelson and a parade of stars when we return with the grand opening spectacular.
Oscar Mayer beef hot dogs, made with pure fresh beef and no fillers. Oscar Mayer, one of the nice things moms do.
Moms take care of the kids they love.
How can you show you're missing?
No kissing, Mom. The guys are watching.
When you're not sure what to say, how do you grab the moment before it slips away?
See you in 10 days.
Nights.
Hallmark introduces to kids with love cards, a whole new way to tell kids how you feel.
Hallmark has a way to make somebody's day.
I wish I were there to tuck you in. Love, Mom.
Hallmark has a way.
New to kids with love cards.
She's the girl of my dreams. She taught me what real love means.
Can't beat the feeling.
What do those Keebler elves want with that big potato?
Taste!
Potato skins got big potato appeal, cause they're made with potatoes and skins that are real.
This much taste comes from using real potatoes, skins and all, the way the Keebler elves do it.
Cheddar cheese and bacon,
sour cream and chives, big potato barbecue, you won't believe your eyes. Big potato taste and skins that are real. Potato skins from Keebler.
The Disney MGM Studios theme park grand opening will continue. Last year, the $6 million man and the bionic woman were reunited. Now it's their greatest reunion ever. In marriage.
Jamie, will you?
And for survival.
Condition yellow, let's go.
As terrorists hold a city hostage, a Terminator sets a deadly trap. And only two people will win the bionic showdown. Next.
Sometimes life in the kitchen can get a bit dull. Starting today, it's going to get a lot more colorful. Introducing Reynolds Crystal Color Plastic Wrap. Brightens everything from leftovers to lunchboxes.
Green, amazing, yellow!
Reynolds Plastic Wrap in colors.
Blue,
very cool.
Reynolds.
Put some excitement back in your kitchen. Wrap it right and bright.
She's gonna hate me.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Bartholomew Lombardi.
Bartholomew? Bartholomew.
Bart Lombardi's on a mission. He'll stop at 7-Eleven, the only place he can pick up the ultimate cool. Slurpee. Thick, smooth, and icy cold in lots of flavors. Even Coca-Cola. Oh, and two straws.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Bart Lombardi.
Slurpees.
In my science class.
Only at 7-Eleven. The sign of the times.
Tonight's Cash 3 lottery numbers are...
I not only saw my first movie before most of our audience's grandparents were born on television in 1933, 6 years before anyone had a television in their home. The occasion was the Chicago World's Fair, and one of the attractions featured a huge black box on one side of the stage and a very, very small screen on the other. The big black box took one's picture, and there, miracle of miracles, the picture appeared simultaneously on that little screen across the stage. I panicked my companions by doing an imitation of an act we'd just seen, a man who actually played two clarinets at once. Fortunately, I did not imitate another act we had just seen that made an even greater and more lasting impression on me, by the way, Sally Rand, the fan dancer. A few years later, on April 30th, 1939, exactly 50 years ago today, the first commercially transmitted TV program was broadcast. Few people saw it, of course. Most Americans only heard about it, sitting in front of their family radios. The TV broadcast was of the President, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, speaking from the World's Fair in New York. The theme of the 1939 fair was The World of Tomorrow. And certainly, television has had an enormous impact on all of our tomorrows. We've rejoiced together and grieved together. We've taken our TV cameras to the moon, and we've seen our little planet from afar. And that's given us a new understanding of the need to protect our spaceship Earth and to make life better for all of its inhabitants. So, TV, here's looking at you. Happy 50th birthday.
Thank you, Walter. And that's the way it is. April 30th, 1989, and you are there. Is everyone at a station? Are we ready for the grand opening? Kate, John?
All set, John.
On with the show.
Rue, Estelle.
The welcome mat's laid out. Wipe your feet.
Harry!
All systems go, John.
Dick and the Creole sisters.
We have liftoff, John.
Everything's in?
Okay.
Tony Randall.
My area and I are prepared beyond belief.
Okay, I guess we're as ready as we'll ever be. Let's get this show on the road. Magic person, it's all yours.
Riding in the first car of the Parade of Stars are Bette Midler and Michael Eisner. Lauren Bacall seems happy to be here with her children, Leslie and Steve Bogart and Sam Robards. Kevin Costner is here with his family, too. The radiant Cicely Tyson is accompanied by Jack Valenti. Oscar winner Sissy Spacek is riding with her husband and young daughter. Leonard Nimoy and his wife. Mr. and Mrs. Rick Moranis. The lovely, charming Betty White. The director of Star Wars, George Lucas. The very elegant Audrey Hepburn. Harry Anderson riding with his wife. A car full of Mouseketeers joins the parade. That's Keisha Knight Pulliam in the middle there, the youngest star of The Cosby Show. And how better to end the Parade of Stars than the Minnie Mouse, Mickey, and Minnie in a lovely new dress.
On behalf of the Walt Disney Company, I hereby declare the Disney MGM Studios theme park open. Let the magic begin.
The Pointer Sisters sing, I'm So Excited. You'll be too when you watch this.
We'll be right back.
Touch of authenticity for the front of the Chinese theater, immortality in cement. Celebration will return with George Burns and Willie Nelson.
A double pleasure's waiting for you. A double pleasure from Double Mint Gum. A double great feeling, making you realize Double Mint's the one for you. Double fresh, double smooth, double delicious to chew. A double pleasure's waiting for you.
It seems like yesterday the Millier girls were in their strollers. Today things are changing. I'm State Farm Agent Dee Ray. After Shannon and Stephanie came along, the Milliers needed our family insurance checkup. I showed them ways they could update their family coverage to cover their bigger family. Like every State Farm agent, I work with a family to help keep their insurance up to date. Keeping up with the girls? That's their job.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Prince Charming is the little dog who is best in show at Westminster. And this is the first time in history a Pomeranian has ever done this.
Olga Baker, top breeder of champion Pomeranians.
I'm so glad that a dog food company finally came up with a product just for these little guys. Pedigree Select Dinners is perfect for the small dogs. Just look at this. This is the beef select dinner. Smells like fresh meat, looks like fresh meat, and the dogs love it. This is what we've been waiting for, and it really works.
New Pedigree Select Dinners, recommended by top breeders.
So what do I get if I beat you, Merlin?
FTD Celebrate Bouquet.
Hey, that's nice.
It's a great way to celebrate a hard-earned victory.
Okay, but what if I don't beat you?
Well, then you get an FTD Pick-Me-Up Bouquet. It's a perfect gift when nothing's going your way.
Hey, that's nice, too. Golly, I can't decide which one I want.
Let me make it easy for you.
The FTD Celebrate and Pick-Me-Up Bouquets. Two great ways to send a feeling that never ends.
How about two out of three?
Now back to the grand opening celebration.
John Ritter speaking to you from the Earful Tower here at Walt Disney World, where the opening ceremonies continue for the brand new Disney MGM Studios theme park. But before we continue, there's something I've always wanted to do. Indulge me, please. Fly, dive! Yes! Thank you, I've always wanted to do that. I need to get that out of my system. But we're going to momentarily leave the celebration to go over to our concert stage for a performance by one of our younger entertainers. Please welcome George Burns.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. And it's nice to be here. Nice to be here. It's nice to be anywhere. And thank you for that standing ovation. But it kind of worries me. As a rule, an entertainer gets a standing ovation at the end of the show. You're afraid I wouldn't last that long, huh? I'll be around long. I gotta stick around. This is a brand new tuxedo. I'm dressing right next door to the Pointer Sisters. And there's a little hole in the wall, but I didn't plug it up, let the kids enjoy themselves. I've been a show business practitioner. Morty, help me with that stool.
Sure.
That's it. Okay?
Yeah.
Now right? Let me help you back to the piano. Where was I? Oh, yeah, I've been a show business practically all of my life. I've done everything. I played the front end of a horse, the back end of a horse. I did a roller skating act. I was a singer, a dancer, a monologist, a straight. You name it, and I tried it. Then at the age of 79, I became a dramatic actor. I did a movie, The Sunshine Boys, and I won an Academy Award. Thank you. And I found out the most important thing about acting is honesty. And if you can fake that, you got it made. Then at 81, I played God. I played him, thank you. I played him without makeup. And at 92, I wrote a book, Gracie, a love story. Turned out to be a bestseller. Thank you. Let me tell you about Gracie. Gracie played a dumb dame on the stage. The whole world thought she was dumb, but not Gracie. Gracie thought she was smart. When Gracie said these strange things and you didn't understand it, she felt sorry for you. Gracie never told a joke, she explained it to you. Like I came home one night, I said, what are we having for dinner? She's roast beef. I just put two roasts in the oven. I said, why two? She's why, because when the little one burns, that means the big one is done. Then I said, why did you put the pepper in the salt shaker and the salt in the pepper shaker? She said, I'll tell you why. Because you always get mixed up. And now when you do, you'll be right. Anyway, Gracie was special on the stage and very, very special. Now hold on to your seats. Here's my opening song. I got to stand up to do this. Morty, will you take the stool? Here's a song written by Leslie Bricus and Anthony Newley, and it tells you just the way I feel. Okay, let's do it. You realize we're living today, I'm happy to say, in a good old, bad old days, taking the breaks, making mistakes, the good old, bad old ways. Some people say they long for the old days, to take them way back when, but I'd rather stay right here with the gold days than go through that again. Seems to me you're either out or you're in, you lose or win. In these sad old, glad old days, you're poor or you're rich, who knows which is which anyways. We're living on time, we're having to borrow. No one knows if we will live to see tomorrow. But nevertheless, I guess we gotta confess, these are the good old, bad old days. Day by day, you're either up or you're down, king or clown. good old, bad old days. It's heaven or hell, hail or farewell, the good old, bad old days. I don't want to hurt myself. Don't you realize, come rain or come shine, they're yours, they're mine in these crazy, mad old days. And if they play in my key, I'll wait for the curtain to raise. I'll sing all my songs, put on my makeup, right until the day that I forget to wake up. I'm happy to say, I'm living today in these good old, these bad old, in these good old, bad old days. Thank you very much. You know, when I first came out, I said, all you need is a great opening and a great closing. Well, you just heard my great opening, and now you're going to hear my great closing. You've been a charming audience, and I had a wonderful time, and thank you very, very much.
While the pageantry continues at this fantastic celebration, let's go over to the Indiana Jones Epic Stunt Spectacular, where thousands of opening night well-wishers are enjoying a concert performance by an American legend, Mr. Willie Nelson.
On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. Way to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. And music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Should have. If I made you feel second best, girl, I'm sorry I was blind. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. all those lonely, lonely times. I guess I never told you that I'm so happy that you're mine. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. And give me, give me one more chance to keep you satisfied. I'll keep you satisfied. I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. You were always on.
July 17th, 1955, the opening of Disneyland. October 1st, 1971, the opening of Walt Disney World. October 1st, 1982, the opening of Epcot Center. April 15th, 1983, Tokyo Disneyland. And tonight, April 30th, 1989, the Disney MGM Studios theme park.
Hooray for Hollywood!
Get your reef. Tonight's falling down more than dance. Cast the dream of romance for the scene where the villain is mean. That's entertainment. A show that is really a show sent to us with a kind of a glow in parade. The yellow room is the way.
Well, we've done it. We've officially opened the Disney MGM Studios theme park. And even though we're saying goodbye, the business of making shows continues down there in the studios and on the drafting desks of the animators. You see, because of you, show business never ever stops. The magic of movies and television continues. So it's not goodbye, just until next time.
Good night.
See you soon.
So long. Be good.
Au revoir.
Good evening.
Pleasant dreams, everybody.
See you at the movies.
Good night, everybody.
People are reaching for the real cola taste of Diet Coke. The real one.
Just for the taste of it.
The move is on to Diet Coke.
Diet Coke.
The new Chevy Lumina has the rust protection of two-sided galvanized steel body panels to guard it from the elements, no matter how severe they get. Introducing the 1990 Family Lumina from today's Chevrolet.
Blanks.
Until now, you couldn't get Corvette's rear suspension technology in a family sedan. But today, there's the 1990 Family Lumina from today's Chevrolet.
What makes everything so whip-smacking, lip-smacking, ah, good? Cool Whip's the one, that whipped creamy taste.
You know, I've never dealt well with guilt. I don't even touch food that makes me feel guilty. So I eat Wheat Thins. They're made with whole wheat. They're baked, not fried. I can love them and not hate myself in the morning.
This is Epcot Center. Epcot Center at Walt Disney World in Florida.
Hi, I'm Minnie Mouse.
Minnie!
It's a Minnie Mania May.
I'm so excited.
As we roll out Minnie's many memorable moments with Disney's main mouse.
Who could ask for anything more?
I could.
So much for special effects.
See if America's favorite female toon can hold one.
I give you my heart.
Elton John, Vanna White, Robert Carradine, Suzanne Summers, and the magical world of Disney's Totally Minnie.
It's totally hot!
Next Sunday. Imagine you're white in a diner when everyone suddenly sees you as a black man.
In the South in 1955, that is dangerous.
You experience prejudice.
He's gone too far.
And rage.
It doesn't end with a sheriff.
Well, that's entirely up to you.
Then your family will be forced to pay a terrible price.
What are you waiting for? We don't accept colored here.
The hell with the law.
Sam, you gotta get out of this.
Quantum Leap moves to its new night, Wednesday.
What makes a rainbow bend? Where does the universe end? To know the world from A to Z.
Discover science and technology.
Where is the dinosaur? What's on the ocean floor? To know the world from A to Z.
Astronomy, biology, chemistry, zoology, science and technology.
It's fun, you'll see.
A public service message from the National Science Foundation.
Amid our celebration, we pause to remember a star among stars. Lucille Ball taught the world that to be in love with Lucy was to be in love with life itself. We will miss her.
Next, Lee Majors and Lindsay Wagner star in the Bionic Showdown. And Monday night, hold on to your aliens. The Richter scale's at an all-time high, and Alf shaking and quaking when he experiences his first earthquake. How come these things never happen on Melmac? Then TV or not TV, that is the question. There's mischief and mayhem on the NBC comedy Nearly Departed, Monday.